of C programming and data structures. Today's session, we will be understanding what is the importance of programming language, how it is interacting with the system, what is the necessity of learning programming language and why it is so important in industry today. Let us quickly understand why C programming language. When you want to interact with the computer, when you want to interact with the system, what helps you in interacting with the system? Yes, the answer is programming. Programming gives you a power to command to the computer. We can increase the power of the computer by programming, providing different instructions and operations to be done in a faster and an easier and a simpler way. Not only that, programming is important to automate, calculate, analyze, manage and process the data and the information in an accurate manner. Hence, it reduces the human effort. Isn't it interesting? Yes, it is interesting because it reduces the human effort. The tendency of programming makes you interact with the system in a better manner. Let us understand what is the history of C programming language. What is the evolution of C programming language? As you can look into the slide here, you can find out the evolutions and how different scientists have improved the programming language by different necessary research and development. Now, long ago, how did people interact with the system? Were there any programming languages? They had to write code in machine understandable language. And that was none other than the binary language, which was represented in terms of zeros and ones. Writing a single statement in a bit pattern was a real complicated job and hence was a really time consuming job. Just consider a simple word or a sentence and try converting it into a binary language. Looking into the complexity, you may say, "I quit," right? To overcome this complexity of writing code in bit patterns, assembly level language came into picture. Assembly language was introduced where you don't need to write code in terms of bit patterns. Assembly language consists of instructions, which is also known as an instruction set. Not only that, consider a simple addition of two numbers. When you want to add two numbers in terms of binary language, you need to convert each number into an 8-bit pattern and then perform the operation, which is a really complicated job. But when you talk about an assembly language, you have to just provide a simple instruction, say add A, B, which is going to do a job. Now, when I talk about A, B, A and B are these two variables which are holding values. Now, what is variable? How variables hold value? All these things we will understand in our upcoming session. When assembly language was easier to remember, it was easier to program, then why C programming language came into picture? This is a simple question arised in everyone's mind, right? Yes. Now, if you go back then in 1969, Unix operating system code was developed using assembly level language. But the major problem was the portability. Now, what do you mean by portability? Portability is nothing but you cannot port your program from one system to another system. It would not support. Running the same code on different platform or different machine, which was not supported by assembly level language, since it acts different according to the different machine. So then, in 1972, Unix operating system code was rewritten in C programming language. They say that this was the first use of C programming language ever. C has less number of lines of code than your assembly level language and it is more human understandable than assembly level language. Now let us quickly see the important parts or important features of C programming language. Let us explore some of the features of C programming language. Let us talk about the first thing, that is high level language and low level language. Now when you talk about high or low level language, simply these two points to the degree of abstraction. Now what do you mean by degree of abstraction? Degree of abstraction means you are hiding the system level details. Therefore, high degree of abstraction means less effort to the user, that is more friendliness, when you don't require to know in detail about the internal parts of your computer. For example, when you write data into a file, you just save it, you don't bother where it is saved, how much of memory it consumes. This is something which is known as the internal details or internal parts of your computer system. Now, when you talk about low level degree of abstraction means more effort by the user. That means you need to know each and every internal detail of your computer. And for example, when you talk about high level language, there are various high level programming languages such as COBOL, Fortran, Pascal, C++, Prolog, etc. When it comes to low level language, the example is simply assembly level language. One more level, which is known as middle level language, C programming language falls under the category of middle level language. Now, if middle level language comes into picture, it means it is a mixture of both high level as well as a low level programming language. It makes it easy for a programmer and also allows us to access the system level features. It works really closely with the hardware. Example, it gives direct access to the memory using pointers, and it also helps doing bit manipulation using bitwise operators. These are some of the important features of C programming language. Now, when it comes to the next important features of C programming language, it is structure-oriented programming language. Now, when you talk about structure, what does it come to your mind? Yes, it is nothing but the syntax. The syntax of your C programming language is already predefined in the standard C library. Hence, we should always follow the syntax. If we don't follow a proper syntax, we might end up getting certain compile time errors. Now, what is compile time error? All these things we are going to see in our upcoming session. The third and the very important feature of your C programming language is modularity. Now, modularity means it is something where you're dividing your huge lengthy code into simple small procedures, which are also known as modules, which are also known as functions in C. Now, when you talk about functions, how to write a function, how to declare, define a function, all these things we are going to study, where we would be more concentrating on functions in our upcoming sessions. The next and important feature of C programming language is efficient. It is efficient and it is faster, yet it is simpler. Right? The applications of C programming languages are, it is, as we have already seen in the previous case, as I told you that Unix operating system was one of the major parts of development in C programming language. Apart from that, it is also used for developing system level features and software applications like Linux kernels, device drivers, operating systems, editors, graphical user interfaces, and also games. It also provides you a rich set of libraries and header files which make you write programs in a better and an easier form.
Now let's get through a simple Hello World program and understand each line of the code. I would request all of you to install the code blocks. The procedure of installation is discussed further in the same session, so you can follow the steps and understand. We are going to implement and execute all our C programming codes in our code blocks environment. Now, without wasting much of our time, let's get started with the code. Here is a simple Hello World program, as you can see right here. The very first line written in this code is nothing but the commented line. Now, these double slashes that are written over here is a commented line. Now, the commented line would be ignored by the compiler. Now, actually, what is a compiler we'll be discussing. Now, let us understand why it is ignoring these lines. The lines that are commented are ignored by the compiler because these lines are for users and developers for their better understanding. It's not a part of the coding. Now, if you can see, this entire code over here is known as a source code. The entire file, which consists of the program is nothing but the input, which is acting like a source code. The line is the header file that is written right after the commented line. Right? So this line is known as a preprocessor directive that is pre-processed by the preprocessor. Now let's understand what is a preprocessor. A preprocessor is nothing but it is a program that is invoked by the compiler. That is, before compilation, the preprocessor would preprocess the code that the line starts with hash. Its job is to replace the content of the file, that is stdio.h. Now stdio.h is nothing but it stands for the standard input output with a .h extension. Hence, it consists of declarations that is none other than prototypes of certain predefined functions such as printf and scanf. Now, what are these functions? We will be studying in the upcoming sessions. Now, the source code has been expanded to the pre-processed code. Now, it sends the code to the compiler for compilation process. Now, what is a compiler? Compiler does the conversion of the code into machine level language. Now, something like compiler is a translator, which is going to take up the input as a source code and it is going to convert the code into machine understandable language and it is going to execute. So, it's acting like a translator between the programmer and the machine. Next, in the next line, we are having int main. Int main followed by the curly brackets, that is nothing but the scope of your main function, which indicates the life and the death of your main function. Normally, the C code consists of two important things, that is nothing but functions and variables. Now, I'll quickly go through what is a function and a variable. We're going to discuss it in the later sessions in detail. For now, let us understand what is a function. Function means it is a group of statements enclosed within a scope that performs certain operations or tasks. Variable is nothing but these are entities that holds value. So we will be discussing this in the upcoming session and work with this more and more to get a pace of programming. Now in this example, we have a function named as main. The purpose of this main function is to print hello world on my output screen. One important note over here you have to note down is that you may have many functions written in your program, but the actual compilation begins from your main function, which is known as an entry point of your program. Compiler looks for the main to start the compilation of your program. If this is missing, even if you have written many different functions in your program, then it would fail to compile your program. The main function also has a return type, that is int. Can you see that? In the line, it is written int main. Now, what is this int? What does it actually do? Now, int is nothing but it is a return type. Now, the main function has a return type, that is int, which accepts only integer, that is return after the execution of all the statements in it. If you can see in my program, I have returned a zero. It indicates if your statements executed successfully, then it would return a zero and exit from your function. The next statement here is the printf statement. This is an output function which helps us to print the output on the output screen. If you can see, it prints hello world, that is enclosed within the double quotes. Anything that is written within the double quotes will be printed as a message on the output screen. And then a semicolon written right after the printf statement indicates that it is the end of your printf statement and it is terminated. So hope you understood a basic simple hello world program. In our upcoming sessions, we would be studying more complicated and different programs and different concepts as well. Thank you.